see what kind of trouble we can go get into. Welcome everybody. I am inside Cousin Eddie. Started my day off in Central Florida over in Haines City, not far from Kissimmee area. Had to do a little bit of work there. Then I had to come up here to Cousin Eddie, which is great because I got inside Cousin Eddie and I had this package from Captain Jack with an amazing t-shirt. Once again, Captain Jack, thank you so much. So what is today's video gonna be? I don't know. When I first started shooting this morning, I figured, you know what? Why not just take you through my day? We start getting into the truck, getting into Cousin Eddie, and you guys can just tag along with me, see what I'm doing throughout the day. I know one thing I gotta do, get my DOT physical. Really fast. As I start my day, would you look at this? Kind of hard to read. I don't know if you guys can see it on camera. Cousin Eddie, established 1995. There's Cousin Eddie. RV maintenance, no shitters, too full. Thank you, Captain Jack Scrapper. If you're not subscribed to Captain Jack, definitely do it. This is an awesome t-shirt. I love it. Well, time to go get in that company car and just go see if we could find anything to shoot some video of. I'm going to try using three different cameras today and putting all the video footage together into one outstanding video. Well, I figured I'd come into town real fast, maybe have a beer. I'm not, by the way, this is not a day off. I'm not on a day off. And another thing, all this video footage here is coming from the idle cam. So when I first started this morning, it was my Osmo Action. This trip here is idle cam. And then after this, I think I'm gonna put some DJI Osmo Pocket in there too. But at the moment, I figured while walking around the villages here, grabbing a bite to eat, just kind of walking through town a little bit, I'll use this camera. And I see right where I'm going. It's right over there. World of beer. Oh God, I can't wait. I need some of that German chocolate cake beer. I'm gonna actually have to talk to Jason, the inventor of this camera, and grab another video of what it's actually doing, because I can deal with all the craziness that this camera has to offer. I know I've shot video about this camera before, and this is not an idle cam video, but it took 15 seconds to start recording after pressing the button, because there's a timer on it, you could see when you started it. So that's kind of, with the current update, it should not be doing that, and I have the proper memory cards in there, so I don't know what's going on. But once it starts recording, it's amazing. And I'm really hoping that this video can be incorporated with the other videos using my, I don't know, maybe I just need a couple beers before I start doing this. And obviously I'm gonna need a little bit more footage to be able to put stuff together. So I had to get a couple samples. So ooh, that's some dark beer right there. This one here is another dark beer. This one, he said, is called Basic B Word. I don't want to say it. You know what I'm talking about. Oh, wow. I like that one. Okay. I know what I'm going to have before I go eat dinner. That. The Basic B Word.
This is your one day off?
It's not even a day off, man. It's just like I was supposed to do my physical, so they routed me home to do my physical. So, but the good news is they can't get to me till tomorrow, so which means I can indulge in my favorite beverages. And eat your tacos.
Exactly.
That's the plan. He talked me into it. Tacos and beer. Walk over here to this crossroad, kind of watch the cars go a little bit.
All right,
we'll just have to see. I can't wait to put it in the computer. Every time I shoot video with this camera, I'm just not exactly sure if it worked, if it didn't work, and then with that little delay in the button pressing, it's kind of difficult. The good news is, I mean, there's a giant monitor that's a flippy up screen monitor with this thing, so at least I can see. Okay, when I ordered the food, I said homemade corn tortillas for the tacos. Yeah, that's what we do. It's not what they do. They use burrito shells, but they're homemade. And they're homemade flour tortillas on a taco. Who uses flour tortillas on a taco? Okay, we're going to take it back and let me order something else, but this has avocado on it. It looks so good. Would you guys like that? Ooh, right? That can't be beat. I asked for street tacos. It got something totally different. That looks like it came from sunny California. I'm okay with that.
One thing I wish, though, everything kind of has been working good with this thing. I just wish when you hit the record button, it started recording like that. It would be really nice. Rather than having to sit up here, wait for it to start recording for 15 seconds, then lower the glasses and get to talking. That would be great. Real fast, would you guys look at the dynamic range as we head on up to the sky? It's kind of works really nice. Who makes tacos with flour tortillas? I've always said that. People do, though. I don't know why. That's not a taco. That's an open-faced burrito. But I'm telling you, wow. As disappointed as I was when it came to the table, the flavor and the spiciness of it, whatever sauce that was they put on there, it really went well with that beer. So I was like, I could honestly say I was happy. You happy? You happy? It looks like Reagan almost. So I figured, after a world of beer, after enjoying some pretty savory tacos, I figured I would come over here to Lazy Day RV in Wildwood, Florida, and maybe do a couple tours of some of these amazing motorhomes here. Would you look at this? I mean, I did not make it to the big RV show in Tampa this year, so why not just come to an RV dealer and do some walkthroughs? Here's the problem. I just went inside the sales office and they go, due to the current situation, all the motorhomes are locked up. You can feel free to walk around. You can walk around, look at them from the outside, but Lazy Days is not letting people in on the insides, which, oh, if Cousin Eddie looked like some of these. These are just beautiful, look at that. But they'll just always be on my bucket list. Yeah, I definitely wouldn't mind having one of these neither. Problem is, you have to have a vehicle to tow it with, which is a positive and a negative. That's just two vehicles for insurance. Something like this, like what I have, well, this is far from what I have, but basically the same. I only need one insurance. Oh, now to the Osmo Pocket. Oh, back inside Cousin Eddie. Oh. Now see, this is nice because I can afford Cousin Eddie. He's mine. I don't have to worry about those crazy fees and everything else. But I do want one of those things. Oh my God, do I want one. I think it would be so nice to have a new RV. Something with slides on it, something with a little bit more room. Though, I mean, I really don't need much. It's the cat. She complains. She only has one hallway and it's thin to run up and down, like a thin racetrack. She wants something wide. She wants to be able to bounce off the walls and have plenty of room. She's like a monkey. But yeah, it looks like at the moment, It's just me, Cousin Eddie, and the cat. No new Cousin Eddie in my future. Probably for many, 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 many years. Anyway, it's time to start getting some footage off of this. And off of this. And the one I'm talking to you guys on. And see if I cannot put it together in one video. We're going to try it. We're going to see how this works. Anyway, guys, until the next one, thanks for hanging out with me today at Worlds of Beer in the Villages, Florida, Lazy Days RV in Wildwood, Florida, and here inside my home, my humble abode, Cousin Eddie in Wildwood, Florida. Until the next time, I love you all. Peace out, everybody.